In this full episode of Perth Fishing TV, I team up with Glen Jakovich as we take on Nick in a challenge to work out what works best, jigging or baits when you go on a charter. Which one do you think will win? Well, let's find out. It's always exciting when there's a new charter in town. And by town, I mean Lancelin. In the past, if you didn't have a boat, it's been tricky to get to the amazing jewfish, snapper and ball chin grounds offshore of this fantastic little place.
Wow, look at that, what a monster baldy.
But when the boat's leaving at 5 a.m, that meant a 2 a.m. wake up and some sleepy punters. And one of those punters I was particularly looking forward to fishing with. One of my favourite people. No, not him. This big fella. Even he'd get up at 2 a.m. for this. The first real force challenge. And to put Nick's claims to the test that bait was forever useless now that jigs had been invented. By his dad, it would seem.
They didn't used to look like this back then. Dad used to make them out of knife handles from the op shop. And we took them over, dropped them down amongst the kings, jigged them up and down, and outfished the Kiwis like you wouldn't believe. All I can remember is my old man screaming, "Get the cutlery out, you lot!" And that's where the jigging craze came from. He brought it back to Australia. Japanese took all of it. And there you go. Knife jigs. Very, very popular method to catch yellowtail kingfish.
So your dad wasn't Mel Leyland in any way, was he?
No, certainly not.
No, certainly not. Okay.
Okay, so here's the rules. We're going to pick teams and then one will fish only baits and the other only lures. Greeny proved there's gold spot trevally in these waters at the end of summer. They're unlikely, but that's 50 points. 80 centimetre jewfish, 25 points. Smaller legal jewies, 15 points. Pink snapper, 10 points. And a whole bunch of points for other stuff, you'll get the hang of it. But if you get a shark, any kind of bust off, or just a head back, you'll lose 5 points for your team. And for my team, I wanted a man who never ever likes to be beaten by a duck or a fish of any kind.
I'm a huge Eagles fan, but I better leave you with some good players, so I think I'll take Brad.
Oh, well, in that case, I'll have to have Jacko. Come on, Jacko.
Which one's which?
The longest straw picks.
Oh, no.
Oh yes!
What are you going to do?
I'll be fishing lures, I believe.
Oh, Jacko, we're baits, mate. I'll tell you what, I'm going to super sub Jacko early. I'm going to come off the bench. This guy here cannot win. You understand?
Okay.
Cannot win.
All right.
May the best man win.
Okay.
And so the battle lines were drawn. Nick with his lures and lots of Shimano, I imagine. And up the front end of the boat, a bunch of sensible people who knew that because it was dark, clearly, baits were going to be an advantage at first. And the big fella did not let me down.
Are you already in?
He beat the horn.
Didn't beat the horn?
He beat the horn.
What we got?
It's a point.
Oh yeah.
It's a point. It's a score.
That's actually a pretty good one, mate.
Break sea cut.
Jacko. Look at this. One.
One.
Zero. Zero. I don't expect that to change too much, I reckon. It'll stay roughly around there. Nice work, mate.
Thanks, mate.
Oh no! Oh, there's a bit of non-synergy happening now. Oh, I'm a bit worried. That's a bad omen and it's all falling apart early.
I couldn't have been more right, because Nick had found my one weakness, getting out of bed in the morning. And unfortunately, I put Jacko's score on the wrong side of the column.
What's happening?
Learn how to count, mate.
Yes, I put
that was Jacko's fish, but now it's mine because of his mistake. Thank you!
Ah, you've got to give him a chance, don't you? And speaking of chances, Brendan the skipper is awesome the way he works. He goes from spot to spot, always giving you the best possible chance to get on a fish. And wouldn't you know it, the next hookup was from, yep, you guessed it,
Jacko's on. Yeah. Here we go. See, the bait's early. Certainly if it's in a fish feed time like it is now. Having baits on early means that if the fish are just looking for something to chow down on after the dark, that's what they're going to be looking for. Nick's already dropped one, and of course that's a good thing. And my super sub is paying dividends pretty early on. What do we got?
Double header, mate.
Oh, Glen.
That's a nice baldy.
Glen, you have just done beautifully, mate.
Oh, thank you.
Let me get my tally.
Nick, is that a 10-pointer?
I think the 5 points.
That's that, isn't it?
Don't you
want to come with or five.
I'll need him.
That's six for me and zero for you.
I think it's six.
Six for me, zero for you.
That's it.
All right. Yeah, Bulchin's 10.
I'm just going to go have a rest.
So Nick, I'm quite happy for you to have that one. We'll call that a gift. Should we call it a gift?
Yeah, well.
Donation. Oh, yeah.
Exit stage left.
But of course, a 10 for that. And he also got a break seat, so you can have your one. We'll have an 11. High five. Great start.
Thank you.
All the baits are working, the jigs. Well, I guess in the right hands they might be working. So back to it, mate, back to it.
That's the end of part one, but don't worry, in part two, Nick makes a comeback.
What do we got on that one, Jacko?
Will it be enough? We'll just have to wait and see. In part one, you'll remember Glen Jakovich and our team of Baitos were taking on Nick and his team that were using nothing but jigs. The idea was to find out, can jigs really hold their own or even beat baits when it comes to deep sea fishing? It began very badly for Nick, with my super sub Jacko taking us to an early lead. Nico even brought his own Shimano scoreboard holder.
Not that I was really that worried. After all, Steve was fishing with a beach rod and Jacko still hadn't worked out he had a foregrip on his.
Lift the jig off the bottom, just.
Now the sun was coming out, I knew the jigs were going to start to really come into their own. Time to make sure the boys had all the right jigs on and were using them correctly.
Just let the boat rock up and down. Maybe half a turn of the handle now. That's it, just let the boat do the work. Another half turn.
So you're not an advocate for thumping the heck out of it?
Black, come on.
Oh, that's a bust off. Is that a bust off?
Mate, you're dreaming. But you
oh, you've got, he's on. He's on already.
He's on already. Hit me on the way. I didn't even hit the ground. Oh, he's just hit me on the way down.
He's a freak. Oh, hello. Nico's on. Oh, it's Nico versus Jacko. That sounds familiar in some way. I don't know what.
You ready? You step back. Step back. Go over me.
Yep. You haven't dropped it, have you, Glen?
Here comes mine. I got one of these stinky bait fishermen trying to wrap me up.
I see points galore coming up here.
Oh, I can see mine. They're Jewies. Yep. Just take it easy there, mate. Just let that one gas off. What have I got? Yep, Jewy. Yep. Ah, beautiful.
What do you got, Nick?
I got a Jewfish that's size.
Oh, no.
Beauty.
Here we go. Look at this. Two Jewfish on two jigs.
No.
Nice work, Team Shimano.
Maybe we really did draw the short straw here.
Well, there you have it. A size Jewfish taken on the new bottom ship 2 Shimano jig. See, this jig's worked as well. And believe it or not, if you have a look at this jig and the difference between it and this little slipper cray that's just come out of this Jewfish's mouth, you'll see that we're matching the hatch quite well.
58, that's legal, that's legal. 20 points for you, 20 points for us.
Yes.
Well, they may have caught some fish, but we're still in front.
Let's go back to that same spot.
Yeah, same spot.
Meanwhile, back at the ranch, the Baitos were busy trying to pull the plug out of the ocean floor. We all know Jacko's a strong boy, but he ain't that strong.
Now, of course, the disadvantage of the point scoring system now is that if you bust off, You lose 5 points. And we do have points to burn, mind you. To burn.
Oh, he's got his rig back.
He's got his rig back?
Oh, no. It's no bust off.
No bust off, mate.
Happy dance.
Too good, mate.
We're still way in front. Not only has he got the skills to pay the bills.
He's even got the sinker back. Oh, he's even caught a fish.
He's got a fish and it's a dive.
Oh, it's beautiful. A bust off.
You don't want to see the fish. You don't want to see the fish.
No, that's not a bust off.
Nah, he got the pointy thing back.
Bust off. Fish.
Now, what's happened is this is a wirracod. And wirracod are famous for living in caves. So what this fella's done, he's come out of his cave, grabbed Jacko's rig, swab neck down under the ledge, and poor old Brendan's had to drive all the way around the other side to pull him back out of the ledge.
I've backed out on plenty of marlin. I've never backed out on a wirra before.
That's it.
Now, we were pretty happy to have found a loophole in the rules that we just invented, but someone just wouldn't leave it alone.
You've got to get minus points for losing your sinker.
Yeah.
He's got a re-rig, it's a bust-off. He's got a re-rig, mate, it's a bust-off.
No, he's not a bust-off, Cam.
It's still fish, mate.
You're going to throw a floater out.
So after part two, the score is 31-21. We're still in front, but you know what? I'm not liking the way this is going at all. What's worse, as the day gets longer, Nick gets even better. So you'll see that in part three, but you don't really want to watch that. You don't want to watch Nick kind of... No, you don't want to watch that.
Go, I walk through everybody's line.
Come on!
Like an amateur.
Move.
When we left our Jigs versus Baits challenge, you'll remember that while Jakovich started off in a blaze of glory, as soon as the sun came up, Nick's jigs had really started to come into their own, and in fact, may have even been more effective. But I didn't want to say that just yet. Unfortunately, I didn't have to, because somebody was onto another fish. And not just him.
Okay, put your tip near mine.
Oh yes, another one. Yes.
Oh yes.
That's a good fish, that's the winner.
Go over here. Put it in gear, put the reel in gear.
Coach Hocking there, giving the instructions.
Oh, look at this.
All the fish are on.
Yelty.
Oh my goodness me, that is one of the biggest harlequin fish I've ever seen, Nick.
That is tip. What do you reckon of that one, Jacko?
But Jacko wasn't in the mood for more talking. He just kept on whining.
That is the biggest harlequin fish I've ever caught.
I've never seen one bigger than that, mate.
Yeah, look at the beautiful colours in that.
Glen racked up yet another ball chin, but it wasn't enough, because soon everyone on a jig was getting onto a fish.
On the bottom ship too, Shimano jig. What a beautiful harlequin.
I got to admit, as much as I've been pulling the what out of you with Shimano, boy, that stuff's really worked, hasn't it? Yeah. No wonder people pay the extra, because those jigs are insanely good.
And how much more enjoyable is it to use an outfit that weighs half the weight of most of the other outfits that you use? That's a 30-pound jig stick, capable of catching anything from this to a 30-kilo jewfish. Weighs as light as a feather. Fantastic. Give it a try.
Was he talking to you or me? Well, regardless, it seems like maybe he was right. And even though Jacko just kept on pumping in the fish, the jiggers did too.
I was going to say is that you think you got it on your jig, but then I don't have it on my jig anymore. What a shame.
Wait a second.
You sure shows the current?
Here we go.
Oh, what the?
Maybe you guys might want to get some Shimano jigs out.
The big fella tried to stare him down, but that was no good. Nick was on a roll now, and there's nothing we could do to stop him.
All jokes aside, Nick, you drop a fish when your baits are gone. You're not going to hook it again, are you? But now you're on for the third time.
Well, the beauty of jigging is you're fishing on the way down, you're fishing when you get there, and you're also fishing when you're coming back up.
Oh, I got colour. I got the nice colour.
Nice dewy. What do you reckon, Jago?
Yeah, it's nice colour.
Up with everybody.
Done well there.
Oh, I think it might be somebody else.
Somebody else.
Oh,
that's somebody else.
Those bait plebs have tangled me up.
Yeah,
the baits have got it.
Yeah. Well, that might be more points for us.
Oh! Where's that other line?
And of course, the inevitable bloody protest.
You amateurs up the front there that tangled my fish up and cut the line off.
Take it up for the third umpire. Just go upstairs to the third umpire. Up, sir. Tells you, mate. Get on that.
All right, mate.
I think you'll agree that the third umpire was inconclusive at best. But if Jacko's sinker wasn't 5 points off, then I guess we've got to give it to him. Unfortunately, with all those fish coming on board, when we tallied things up, it was not looking good for me and Jacko.
What do you think the most vital ingredient of catching fish on a charter with jigs is? I know it's one thing on your own boat. When you've got a whole line of lures and baits, what do you really have to keep in mind?
The quality of your jig, for a start. A lot of people will go out there and buy the cheapest jigs that they can find. Unfortunately, they don't really work that well. Quality jigs will outfish cheaper jigs 10 to 1. And it's all about the action that you induce into the jig. A lot of people try to work the jigs really fast. No need to. Not for demersal species anyway. Just drop the jig down to the bottom. As soon as it hits it, just flick the bail and just lift the jig off the bottom. Just let it flutter back down. A couple of little flutters, back down again. Don't even turn the handle. Just let that jig just flutter around about a foot off the bottom. Once it comes up about a metre or two, just drop it back down again.
And often it's the drop that you get the fish. In fact, more than often, it's almost always that.
That's right. I'd almost liken it to squid fishing. You catch a lot of squid when your jig's just free floating down through the water. Same with your jigs. Unless you're jigging for Seriola species, like Samson fish, yellowtail kingfish, and amberjack. Then you want to work the jig quick, which is more of a jig, 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 jig. Really get that jig up and moving. But for demersals, just drop it down, flutter it along the bottom, they'll find it, and they'll eat it.
So at the end of part three, Nick's made a big comeback with his team Shimano on the jigs. Will they win? Oh God, I hope not. You'll find out in part four.
So far in our baits versus jigs challenge, things have been pretty close. Now it's finally time to see what wins.
Another 10 points.
This could be a bigger one. Oh, it's just a big jew fish.
Oh, yes.
Which one?
Nice size.
Oh, that's a nice one. Yes.
Oh. Awesome. And suddenly Nick has decided he's going to ruin everybody's day. Go, I walk through everybody's line.
Come on. Lift your rod tip up. Go over.
He is going to do a lap of the entire boat. And now he's up the front.
And the little tiny hooks. Is there anything? The only thing that's got me worried about this fish at the moment are these tiny, tiny little hooks. A lot of people play fish judging on their leader size and their line class size. If I was to do that, I'd lose this fish because I've got two very small size 4 jig hooks. And they wouldn't have much purchase on this fish, so shaking his head around. Time to go back up to your armpit. Yeah, it's definitely a sambo. He's hanging right in there. Colour. Yep. Oh, there's another one with him. There's another one with him, guys. Do you want to drop a jig on it?
Yeah, there's some more fish down there. Get some jigs in.
Drop a jig.
Now, you know,
a friend.
What happens a lot of the time with Seriola species is they have a friend that follows them up. It's not a very big Samson fish, but as I said before, it's caught on a very small set of hooks. So what I'll do is just lead this over to the net. Another fish for the jig.
I'm starting to have to admit that maybe the jigs are winning.
Well, not just yet, but it was getting real close. And even though Nick told Team Shimano to jig up that spare Samson fish, they couldn't do it. So he did.
These jig outfits are very light, very enjoyable to fish with. However, they have very little give in them. So if you have a sore back, the best way to fish them is allow the boat to rock up the swell as it's doing now, then you wind down the other side. I don't have to lift the rod, the boat's doing it for me. It's nice and smooth. Let the rod come up, take the line under the reel. Just remember, these are very, very small hooks. They're only that big. Fish's mouth's probably that big. We don't want to pull them out. Big jewfish now will start to float up and land up out there. A big Samson fish, you'll dig in under the boat here. That's how you tell the difference. If I was to pull the hook now, I'd know exactly what it is. It's a Samson fish under the boat. If I pull the hook out there, I'd be devastated because I know it's a 20 kilo jewfish and it's about to float up out there without my hooks in it. Here's our fish. Righty, are you ready? There we go. First thing you do, flick your bail arm over when the fish comes over the side. That way there's no pressure on your rod. You're not going to snap the tip off. Jig rods do not like coming in under an angle like that. Bottom ship two jigs by Shimano. Go and check them out.
No matter what jig you use, just make sure you give them a go, because this was the final score. Can you believe it? Well, yeah, I can. And I think Nick sums it up perfectly.
If you want to stand there and fish with big stinky clumps of bait and clumps of lead, hurt your back all day winding it up and down and then throw it all away at the end of the day when you go home, or get some jigs.
I hate to say I agree with him, but I agree.